everyone. My name is Aparna Saxena. I'm the CEO of Torajo Melo. Torajo Melo is an impact business headquartered in Jakarta, Indonesia. Founded in 2008, we are focused on collaborating with women artisans from rural communities so that we can provide livelihood to rural communities and alleviate systemic poverty, preserve cultural heritage of weaving in Indonesia, and prevent breakdown of families and community due to the outward migration of rural women. We follow the following UN SDGs. Number one, no poverty. Number five, gender equality. Number 12, responsible consumption and production. And number 13, climate action. Why were we created? As I emphasized, our aim is to reduce poverty so that we can prevent the forced migration of women workers, which in fact affects and causes loss of cultural heritage and then leads to degradation of communities. Our vision is to alleviate systemic poverty by creating a sustainable ecosystem for women artisans across Indonesia. We are very serious about our impact mission and we want to create sustainability at scale. We do this via our three C's: commerce, community collaboration, and consultancy. Commerce is our slow ethical lifestyle brand where we showcase products that are created from handwoven textiles. Community collaboration is where we go and work with communities and train them on product design, development, marketing, and make them aware of the trends. And consultancy, wherein we work with businesses big and small so that we can help them do ESG and CSR in a better manner. Our new focus is to ensure that across all our processes, we are sustainable, including our partners and our customers. We want to implement ethical business practices across our end-to-end supply chain, and our aim is to work towards creating a circular economy around decentralized rural communities. Therefore, sharing the three sustainability pillars that we have: cultural sustainability, so that the heritage of indigenous weaving in Indonesia can be continued; environmental sustainability, so that we have resilient and traceable supply chains around rural economies; and social sustainability, so that we can provide a sense of agency and financial independence to women in rural communities. Sharing a bit about our communities, we currently work with 11 communities, largely in outlying areas of Indonesia, and we reach about 1,100 weavers. Our communities are across South Sulawesi in Toraja, West Sulawesi, Mamasa, and in Nusa Tenggara Timur, Adonara, Lembata, and Larantuka, and then West Timur, which is again part of East Flores, it's Maubesi, Biloto, Oesena, Gela, and Maumere. How do we select these communities? Our criteria largely depends on where they are placed, and they are generally excluded, essentially where they have a trend of outward migration. These are also areas where we have seen there is little or no government or developmental organization support. And finally, we definitely have to have weaving as an entry point. So we work with weaving communities. So they need to have weaving capacity and capability. Our products, we have around four product lines, starting with what is called as the art cloth, known as tenun in Indonesian. And tenun is basically the actual hand-woven textile that these women weave. It is indigenous to every community. The motifs and patterns belong to these communities, and they are unique as we move from one community to the other. We have apparel line, both for male and female. Largely, we've been focused on female. And in that, what we do is we take the hand-woven textiles, combine it with fabric, and try to create contemporary cuts in clothing. Recently, we launched our 2021 collection, which is specially focused on Gen Z and millennials, as we want to reach out to younger audiences. We also create products that can cater to B2B markets, which is small goods, accessories, and gifts. And during holiday season, we do invite a lot of attention from these in this range. And finally, we have a home decor line where we find place in your homes with our placemats, tablecloths, and so have it. I will briefly now share about the women who make our work worthwhile. Stories of two women from indigenous communities who we have worked with and who we are proud to say we have been able to make a difference in their lives. First is Ina Agnes Sai. Ina basically means, it's an honorific for a woman, yeah. And it's generally a term used in eastern parts of Indonesia. She's from the island of Lambata, and she's a master weaver. She's a third generation weaver. She's trained her second and also the third generation in it. By working with Torajamelo, she was able to have a sustainable income, support her family, and also she was part of our exhibition that we did with National Textile Museum in 2017, where she was able to share her story with a wider urban audience. Moving to Mama Ita, also known as Mary, which is actually her name, in indigenous communities, it's quite a common practice that women are referred to as mothers of their children. So therefore, Ita is the name of her daughter. Mama Mary or Mama Ita has an interesting story herself. She's a single mother, and by working with Torajamelo, she became a master weaver. She trains the weaving collective that we work with in Toraja, and she's been able to support her daughter's education from start till the end, and also support her mother and her sister sustainably. Even during the pandemic, she was able to have a fairly good life because she was able to feed herself and also her family. As Torajamelo, I'd like to summarize by saying that we are committed to resetting the standards for social enterprises in Indonesia. We will never compromise our integrity and commitment, and we will continue to improve livelihood of weavers against the allure of exponential growth. By setting gold standard in circular economy approach internally and also externally within the industry, and we will keep challenging mindset and changing mindset of communities and the ecosystem, and work towards self-sufficiency so that we are not overly dependent on owners and developmental organizations. Thank you.